Hey everybody, I'm Ian Lobos with Massive Property Group. Welcome back to my video blog. Today, we got a little bit of a funny one. Mood is really important in a house, period. Bedrooms, living areas, kitchen, the mood is really important. So today we're gonna talk about the 8 things that'll kill the mood for a buyer in your bedroom. Stay tuned. All right, number one, a litter box. For your cat or your dog or your ferret or guinea pig or anything like that, when buyers walk into a bedroom, they want to know that it's comfortable, quiet, calm, and it's a good place for whatever they do in the bedroom. Seeing things like litter boxes will severely turn off a buyer. So if you have a pet with a litter box, make sure you put it in a bathroom, a basement, or hide it somewhere else in a corner of the house that's not that important. All right, number two, boudoir photos. Inappropriate photos, enough said. Number three, medical equipment. So we all know that famous CPAP device for sleep apnea. Well, there's other devices and stuff, medical equipment that could turn buyers off and or give away your motivation for wanting to sell the property, especially people that are of a certain age. So make sure that medical equipment in your bedroom is put away before any showings of your house. All right, number four, toys. Toys in the bedroom, and I'm not talking just about kids' toys. We're talking about adult toys too. You would be shocked how many people report adult toys being a huge turnoff when they're on a showing. So, if you've got adult toys and or kids' toys, take them out of the room, put them away, and make sure you hide them so you don't turn a buyer off. What may be a turn on for you may not be a turn on for somebody else. Okay, number five, lotions, potions, put them away, you know what I'm talking about. Number six, a standard one, laundry, dirty or clean, hampers, things like that. Unless it's neat and organized and has a lid on it, laundry and any other dirty clothes or clean clothes folded need to be in their appropriate places, in a closet, or just out of the way. All right, number seven, multiple locks on bedroom doors. One lock is totally fine, but if you really want to turn a buyer off, more than one lock, deadbolts, additional locks, they're gonna turn a buyer off because they're gonna wonder about safety in your home and around the home. So if you've got multiple locks on the door for showings, just remove those. All right, and finally, number eight, multiple mirrors in your bedroom that are used for more than dressing. Yes, I know there's an additional meaning to all this stuff. It's really important to know. So if you've got multiple mirrors, and I mean more than two, in the bedroom, and they're not in the spots that people would have a figure that they should be, remove them for your showings. Just keep it safe. Okay, so that wraps the video up. I know this has been a fun one and a different one, so read into it however you want. It's fun. And it's also important to know because psychologically, when a buyer walks into your house, they have to feel comfortable. They've got to feel safe and they've got to be turned on by your house, however you want to interpret that. So remember, this video is really important. Although we're having a lot of fun with it, pay attention to these things because these are the things that turn buyers off and cause buyers not to write contracts. And at the end of the day, when you're looking to sell your home, you want a contract in hand for the most amount of money possible. So follow the advice here and call me if you have any questions. So if you have a topic that you want me to shoot, I really appreciate everybody who sends their information in and asks tons of questions of us. Picking our brain and our expertise on so many aspects of real estate. So if you have a video that you want us to shoot, you can email, call, text, DM anytime you want, and we'll figure out all the details on it and shoot a video and send it to you. If you wouldn't mind, send this to all your family, friends, share it out on social media. And if you love the video, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube page. As always, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.